skating and stuff like that. It was really, really good. And at the game, meeting all the boys, and I had a great day, but it was, I don't know, just, it didn't, I see I'm getting older as well, so see, I think, see when you're getting a bit older, maybe, because, I don't know,
Aye, because you're getting that sensible and that in your old age, like, though, you're fucking.
aye, so it was a great day, and I enjoyed it. I had my good mate from Liverpool, his lad and two of his pals, I'd name up as well. So three wee Everton fans were at the game. They thoroughly enjoyed it. They loved it.
Right,
So
let's get the phone lines open.
get them all.
I'm sure there's queues.
I'd say there's people.
Yeah.
We should get a big whistle. We
You
can
got
blow
the
it.
phone number again?
I mean, was it no Brendan said once it was great? He said the call's back last night, boys. Nobody phoned that.
I
Just
know.
probably then talk about some of the performances then. It's hard to talk about performances
Well,
because they were so bad. Do you know what I mean?
I've got one to say, mate.
I know what you're going to say, and I would probably agree with you before you start.
I've been critical,
Aye, me too.
Big Keaton. He gave a Rolls-Royce performance on
Yeah,
Sunday. It's a fair play.
100%.
But then again,
100%.
Jason, he fucking who didn't stroll it on Sunday like that?
Aye, you've got a point there. Denier played. I think Denier nipped off for half an hour and then come back on. We didn't know he was away. But it was just, aye, it was. He wasn't getting pressurised, but it's still a pressurised situation. Although the team that he was playing weren't pressurising him, and the boy done really well. And he put a good few balls through, and he can definitely see a pass. So for that, I'll take my hat off to him, and I'm delighted for him, you know.
But see that,
I have to say, that's probably, I mean, I know you were kind of crowing yourself there for picking that team, but I think that team picked itself on Sunday as our best team. I think that is our best team.
well,
But
you know.
if he wants to play that formation, like, no, with the one man up top, then you pick your best players, and you pick the players that are on form. And to me, as I said last week, that Motherwell performance that night could have been one of the best of the season.
Yeah.
And the only change was Lustig coming in for Matthews, and I think that's right, because I think Lustig at the end of the day is a better player than Matthews, and that's not taking anything away from Matthews. I just think Lustig's the strongest fullback there. So I think that team, before the signings, obviously, the two boys coming up for Dundee United, which I'm sure we'll talk about, but to me, that team picked itself on Sunday, because I think Stokes is. I still get. There was a couple of boys in the pubs, and they were like, "I can't believe Stokes has been picked. Henderson's been front." They just didn't like Stokes, and it doesn't matter what he does.
Yeah.
Stokes is one of these guys that people have made their minds up. They don't like him, and so they don't want him in the team. And to me, he's one of the first names of the team sheet this season, because I think he's been outstanding. Him and Azagiri down the left. So I find that strange that people just they stick to a narrative and they don't know how to change their minds. But I
Yeah.
just honestly believe that team picked itself on Sunday, to be fair, like.
But you know yourself, it happens so often that they always throw a curveball in somewhere.
Aye, well, Lennon used to do that a
Aye,
lot,
the old
didn't he?
time.
Yeah.
Aye, fucking like a. He threw in a Miku against Barcelona. Nah, obviously it worked out,
Aye.
like, but I mean.
But aye, there's always some
Aye.
strange, some yeah, you, big Skepovic would start or whatever, and you'd be saying, wait a minute here. But I think Ronnie, hopefully now he's realising that other teams worry about us. Celtic should not be changing any personnel in their teams because of another team in Scotland.
No.
Maybe. You've got an argument for saying because of other situations like the Ross County Park and the weather and things like that. So you can maybe say, right, okay, I'll maybe put it's going to be a bit more of a battle. Then maybe, I don't know, you put another midfielder in or whatever, I don't know, another like defence him. But on reality, we should always just pick our 11 and let them worry about us because we're streets ahead of everybody in Scotland. Absolute streets ahead of them.
I mean, like, James Forrest is probably the only other one that I could really see a good argument for starting that game. But no, just aye, that's our best team. I just
Well,
I'd be interested to see how it shapes up now with the new signings.
that was our best team. It's not our best team anymore.
We'll go on that. We'll go on that in a second.
How does that pan out now with the two boys coming in like
Well,
that?
here we go on that in
Well,
a second. On in a second. I want to talk about a couple of standout moments from. I mean, obviously,
aye. Let's not get ahead of ourselves then.
the game wasn't great. I mean, like, but there was a couple of standout moments. Obviously, Griffiths. I thought Griffiths was fantastic. Right.
Right.
I thought he was like. I mean, he's the most eager player in that team. I think
Yep.
without a doubt. I mean, he's just got that hunger, and you can just see he fucking loves it, and he clearly hates them, right? And smallest, one of the smallest guys in the pitch, smashing header. Their keeper's more or less pinch, right? But Johansson, smashing cross for that goal. I mean, Johansson, tailor-made for big games, for battling games. Didn't even have to fucking do too much in that game. Scott Brown had Ian Black fucking in his jackstrap.
I think Johansson's been excellent this season, but I think that was one of his quieter games. He didn't do too much, but as you say, the ball in for Griffiths, it was quality. The one thing I would like to add about Wee Lee Griffiths, he's got heart of a lion, you know. And he is one of the guys, probably, that we thought, I mean, all the rumours were hearing he was going back to Hibs and things like that. I work a couple, maybe 1 or 2 days a week in Edinburgh with a few Hibbies, and they would have him back in a second. They love the guy.
See, just on that, not to butt in, Jason Weir, there was a Hibs fan in the pub with us, or something, all Hibs tattoos and all that. Like, he enjoyed himself at all.
Right.
And the Huns, like, no, he's enjoying, but he, we're talking about Griffiths and that, like, no, they would have him back in a heartbeat.
Oh, but it's like he would have been the guy we would have thought straight away, you know, Ronnie Dyla, he's going to be a bit of a fitness freak, he's going to be a bit of a disciplinarian, he's, you know, and then you seen at the start, Griffiths was kind of frozen out straight away. And then
maybe he had to learn that he had to screw them up. This is Celtic, you know, this is where he's going to be. And he's done it, obviously.
And that's real pleasing thing, you know. And if he cuts out the antics and the pubs and things like that, then all the better. But don't cut out running to the Sevco mob and giving them at large. You'll keep doing that,
man. Did you watch that video that Joe shared with us earlier?
The slow motion one.
Aye. I'm just jumping in and landing on his 2 feet.
Brilliant. I love that. I was just watching the faces in the background going, he's raging. He's raging.
See, the wee boy eating the crisps. The wee boy's eating the crisps. Raging. they photos of them when you can take with the iPhones and stuff, though. You can make it bigger and you look right at it, and you can see their pain, which is makes it all the better.
Fucking brilliant, man. But I mean, I was glad it was him, because he deserves a big goal like that in a big game, because he has got that heart, like you say. But you mentioned about Dyla, I mean, kind of freezing him out a bit. It could be the attitude, but then again, I think Ronnie Dyla is very much a guy who wants to bring out the best in each player, and obviously is good at that, right? Because, I mean, Lee Griffiths hasn't changed as a player. He might have changed as a person, as a professional. I mean, I think he's probably a better professional now than he was before. But as a player, he's still the same player. Still has that fucking flat out. He will run his bollocks off 60 yards on an empty pitch towards the keeper with the ball. You know what I mean? Just because he wants it that much. And I think that's something that Ronnie Dyla has probably fostered in him. And cultivating that kind of natural sense that Griffiths has and bringing it out of him is going to make him a better player, and is obviously essentially a better player for us and a goal scorer. Because I mean, he's a guy I think that works upon belief and confidence more than anything else. And the more goals he scores, the bigger games he scores in, the better he's going to get. And I think Ronnie Dyla is that guy to build.
I agree with you, but I just disagree with what you said at the end there about I'm running on confidence, because I don't think he's ever not been confident in his life.
I know, but do you not think, though, the more goals he scores and the bigger impact he has on the team?
You're getting it, but I just think he's the kind of guy who'll just go out and give his 100% at all times. He's never been afraid to try things, show some goals, places. I think
you're absolutely right, because, I mean, I think his career has proved that. He's gone Dundee, he's gone Wolves, he's gone Hibs, you know what I mean? And obviously he's had falls and he's got back up again, but I think this is probably his moment. I mean, this is probably his biggest moment in his football career.
Yeah, but hopefully he's realised where he is and what he could become.
Yeah, because if he leaves us, it's only going down, you know. But I'm kind of a Harper here. I reckon he's the type of guy that, see, when he hangs his boots up, he'll still go and play 5-a-sides 3 nights a week and things like that. I think he just loves playing football, you know, and he's got a one-day left peg.
Oh.
And even getting the goal with the head, I mean, he's one of the weakest guys in the park, you know, so that shows you how good their defence is. But fair play to him, you know, and he certainly enjoyed it. And I'm sure I think he was even more delighted that it was in front of that mob. Because he's no stranger to getting it right up someday.
Oh.
So,
I was actually surprised at how many of their players, I'll be honest, I've not just said this, I didn't really follow them at all, you know. I was surprised how many of the players actually knew who they were. Do you know what I mean?
I tell you what, I can
Miller, Foster, I didn't even know that Stephen Smith was still there. Did they go away and come back? I mean,
is that,
I'm surprised. I'm surprised that I knew as many players as I did.
Yeah, I tell you who I knew, right?
I didn't really know. Well, I was at the game, so I wasn't listening to any comment. I didn't know many of them.
I can name the players that I recognise. I recognise Foster only because he kind of came in towards the end of them going to the shit. I recognise, obviously, John Daly. I recognise Miller for clear reasons. Ian Black, McCulloch.
Smith.
Is that the same Stevie Smith, though?
No.
It isn't, are
Did he leave them and come back? No.
I also recognise. I recognise Nicky Law only because I read an article last week calling him the bald Iniesta.
I haven't had a clue who he was to
be. He looked like that when Big Virgil just backhanded him.
It was. Somebody put that up on Vine. It wasn't like when you try to get the ball off an 11th year when you're in 7th year in football. He just fucking swatted him away like a fly.
I've seen that in the lad Bible.
Fucking brilliant, man. It was just fantastic. I mean, it was fantastic because it's good to rub the nose in it, right? But it wasn't fantastic. I mean, did you walk into work on Monday morning looking for Huns, Jason?
Nah. See, I'll be honest with you. You don't engage in any conversation with them any longer about football. That died a few years ago. You just don't. It's like there isn't any baiting, any wine. Yeah, it doesn't happen. You know, and it's like it's not like that anymore. It's they kind of avoid the subject, you know, and they all like Man City and Chelsea now. They'll talk about English football.
I have to say, I enjoyed the Green Brigade's rebound at the start.
Right.
I put it on my Facebook, a Rangers fan commented vile, and I just thought, I'm not even going to reply to that.
Did any of you read that statement for that Rangers supporters? Post, is it?
No, I heard there was a statement out, but I could just imagine.
They're seriously insane.
What did they say?
I don't know exactly, but it was to
the... that banner, was it?
It's to the words of... Celtic, the sectarian Green Brigade, I think they used that, don't quote me, but I think it was, they say they are trying to dehumanise us by using the words monkeys and Huns. They're trying to dehumanise the Ranger support.
Yeah, but essentially we're all monkeys when you think about it. Like,
you're in this creationism and some new anti-religion, you're...
What's this
the banner of the Green Brigade that the monkeys died?
Well, I never seen that. I'm talking about the one that at the going down of the Hun.
That's my number two.
In the morning, we will remember them.
That was good then. They had when the monkeys died and they all brought up.
I seen the blow up monkeys out.
Rangers scarves on.
I seen the blow up monkeys.
Good.
Okay, brilliant. We've been joined by our first caller, possibly only caller.
Please.
Brendan Tehan, the human Adonis that is Brendan Tehan.
Can you hear me, Joe?
What's happening, Brendan? You're right.
Yeah, I'm not too bad. I thought I'd better phone in, being that I was one of the fuckers at the moment when you closed the calls.
You never called in the last thing.
I've just been at work, Harper. You want a good day on Sunday, yeah?
Good, mate. How are you? Were you up at the game, Brendan?
No, I watched it at the Irish Club down
here. Oh, you said that. I seen that.
Yeah, it was fucking... It was jumping down there, but you know the point he's made? Like, right up to the gate, all buzzing for it. But you know when the game started?
Right.
No contest, wasn't it?
Exactly.
It was a joke. It was
I bet you found... Seen the right. Second half, I bet he's were all blathering each other, yeah, talking about horse races and stuff like that.
At 2-0, you knew it was game over, and I didn't even think Celtic out of first gear, to be honest.
Nah.
They're fucking rubbish, man.
Off. I know.
Absolute fucking murder.
Do you know what? See, like a lot of them, because obviously they've I think it's St Johnstone, Inverness, and I think it's St Johnstone and Kilmarnock, is it? They played three Premier League teams in the way to there in the Scottish Cup or whatever, yeah, and they beat them.
They played them all at Ibrox, didn't they?
Aye, but they've beat them, and so they've got that wee bit think to themselves. Well, when we play a better class of team, we raise our game. But no, and I think now a lot of them have realised, fucking hell, you know, that they're dire, you know, and they will be terrified of the draw.
Fucking dead right.
I mean, Scottish Cup.
I tweeted on Sunday, they're 10 years behind us, and we stand still.
Yeah.
Aye.
Do you know what I mean? And we've signed them two boys from Dundee United. They're only going to make it stronger, aren't they? And hopefully we sign a few more in the summer, because obviously we're going to lose Van Dijk, but Nah, they're fucking nah. As soon as that second goal went in, it was.